Hello everyone, thanks for watching this video. So in this video, today we are going to understand how to create the singly linked list in Java. In the program number 1, we understood that how to represent a singly linked list. Okay. Now this is the next program where we are going to create the linked list having multiple node. Okay. So as we understand, to create the linked list, first we should have one class which is private type, okay, and inside the class we should have two variable defined. One is the data and the second is the reference of the next node, okay, and we are going to initialize these two member using constructor or through constructor. Okay, so let's have private static class called list node. Okay, so inside the list node we are going to declare two variable which is again private type. Now we are working for the integer since we are going to insert the int data, that's why I declare as a integer and the variable name is data. Okay, same as private. Now the second variable is the reference of the next node, or we can say this is the reference of the next node, yeah, which we are calling as a next. Okay, now what we are going to do is we are going to write one public constructor which is argument constructor. Okay, public constructor, and we are going to initialize these two variable here. So we are receiving only data from the user. So this dot data equal to data, okay, and this dot next equal to null. The reason is by default this will be a null only. By default the address of the next node is null. By this compilation error should be int. So we are able to create the linked list. So we are good till now. Okay, now our responsibility is to load the data. So let's have the main program. So in that main program, actually we are going to load the data. Okay, so first create the instance of this one. Creating the instance of list node is nothing but initializing the two data member that we have already defined. So we know, right, first node is called head. So since we are creating this one, so we are naming as a, okay, let's have first only, later we will change it, equal to new list node. Okay, so the data what we are going to pass as per our PPT only 10 20 30 40 and 50. So here we are going to pass as a 10. Okay, this first node we created. Okay, now second node we are going to create, list node, again the reference of same, second equal to new list node. Okay, here we are going to pass data as a 20, same list node, third equal to new list node, and here I am going to pass data as a 30. Okay, spelling mistake, yes. Now we are going to again create two more, just copy this one. Okay, and first, second, third, fourth. Fifth. Okay, now we are going to change the data 10, 20, 30. This one is 40 and this one is 50. Good, right? So now what we did is, till now we created one, we defined one linked list. Okay, with this linked list we are loading the data. Where I have created the first node, loaded the data 10. Where I have created the second node, loaded the data 20. Third node 30, fourth node 40, fifth node 50, as per this PPT only. Okay, you can pass any of the value as you wish. Okay, now good, we created the node, but now question is, still we haven't linked the node. Okay, so the question, okay, first we are going to tell you only one thing here is, the first node is also called as head. Okay, so that's the reason first node we can say as a head. Now we are going to do the connection. We are going to establish the link between two node, head dot next equal to second. Okay, listen, understand this line carefully. This is the head, means first node. First node doing the connection through the next to second node, means first node I am connecting to the second node. Now second node I am connecting to the third node. Okay, and third node I am connecting with the fifth node. Okay, so total we have the 5 node only, and all 5 node we did the connection. So we are good now, and we are done also. Okay, let me summarize to you again. Our goal is to create the singly linked list which has the data something like that, 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50. So first we created the linked list where we declared two variables. First one is the data and second one is the reference of the next node. Next node is the list node only. And we initialize these two variables using the constructor, argument constructor, where we are receiving data from the user, only data. So we initialize data to data, and we initialize this next reference to null, since by default the reference value of the node is null until unless we have to do the connection. So we created linked list here, till done. Now our task is to load the data. So to load the data we created the instance. Okay, so we created the first node, this is first node, and we loaded the data as a 10. This created I have second node which is 20. Similar fashion we created total 5 node and we loaded the data 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50. Since we know first node is also called as head, so we rename the first node as a head, but this is actually the first node. Now we are done. Now our third task is to do the linking, means establish the connection. So head dot next equal to second. So first node I am connecting with the second node I am connecting with the third node, and third node connecting with the fourth node, and fourth node I am connecting with the fifth node. After fifth we don't have any node, so just I am stopping connection here. So total I have 5 node, and I have established the connection between each and every node. Okay, and we already loaded the data. Okay, so that is our task. I understand that we cannot able to print anything. If you run as a Java application, you can't get any output. The reason is we are not printing anything. We just created the linked list, loaded the data. Okay, in next program we will understand how to print the data from the linked list. Okay, thanks for watching this video.